Greetings, Urbanites. This is Tovresh Pazan with the iPadBoardGames.org review of Doodle City. Aporta Games has tried something new. They released their new board game, Doodle City, at this year's Essenspiel Festival in Germany, and released an iOS version on the opening day of the festival to promote it. Is the city worth the travel? Doodle City shares DNA with Suburbia and 18XX Crayon Games. Each player is presented with a grid representing a city and draws lines on the grid to connect various buildings. Each game will begin with five squares pre-populated with one or two houses each and one random road segment already drawn. Each turn, the player whose turn it is will throw dice, one blue die and one more white die than each player, or three white dice if playing solo. The blue die dictates which column you can draw on, and the white dice which row. After drawing, the player removes the corresponding white die. Each other player then draws on their own grid, choosing from the remaining white dice. If a green space is selected, another house is constructed. Otherwise, a road is drawn through the selected space. Points are awarded based on what each road connects. Retail stores score 1 point for each house connected at the time the road is placed. Hotel scores 1 for each road segment connected at the time the road is placed. These scores are exclusive. A given player can only score a 5-point hotel once, and there are one-time-only bonuses for scoring 3, 5, 7, and 10-point retail stores that only one player receives. Taxi stands score 4 points when they are connected to at least one other taxi stand. Unlike other scoring opportunities, this can happen whenever they are connected during gameplay. Each player also begins the game with 7 trees. One tree is consumed when you are either unable or unwilling to make a move. A tree is also consumed if you choose a white 6, which lets you freely draw in any available space in the designated column. A blue 6 lets you choose any column without penalty. The game ends when someone achieves the maximum score on a store or hotel, or when a player consumes their last tree. The Doodle City app is fairly basic. It plays the game with few frills. No AI for starters. The only solo option is the solitaire mode, in which you are playing mostly to beat your own high score and to achieve a few achievements. The word achievement implies skill, and there isn't a lot of that here. The achievements rather depend largely upon you getting lucky die rolls and initial placement of your random streets. A very brief tutorial exists, along with a slideshow covering the rules, which can be accessed during gameplay. Multiplay is handled either locally or via Game Center. We weren't able to find many opponents, and we have yet to complete a game, though the asynchronous nature of the dueling solitaire means this game fits fine into busy lifestyles. Badges and notifications both seem to work fine. It's worth noting, though, that not all the graphics in the game's post-it note interface are Retina ready. Doodle City is less a board game than a puzzle presented as a competitive solitaire. The solo mode isn't terribly engaging, but makes for a nice, quick brain workout, though in a rather surprising number of cases the best move seems obvious, given which we aren't really sure why no AI was included. This one is worth a look, but is definitely a try before you buy kind of deal. Bye.